Down the rest is mine. Miss a payment and you pay the fine. Shotgun, turn around, hit the ground, read that sign. This ain't no place to be. Oh Lord, Lord, I got to be free. I got the paper and I read the news. Headline says I got to pay my dues. You can't win here, but you sure can lose. Sign the paper on the dotted line. 33 down, the rest is mine. Miss a payment and you pay the fine. Shotgun, turn around, hit the ground, read that sign. This ain't no place to be. Oh Lord, Lord, I got to be free. The same old place to be. Oh Lord, Lord, I got to be free. I got to be free now. I got to be free. I got to be free. I got to be free. Free.
All right.
Thanks, Richie Grace. Welcome to Songwriters in the Round. My name is Julie Darty, and that was my friend Richard Grace singing another one of his wonderful songs. When did you write that one?
70s.
Yes, sometime
first time
in the 70s.
I applied for a bank loan.
So it's really the bank loan blues.
There you
That's
go.
The subtitle right there. I'm so glad to have so many great songwriting friends. We have Paul Cucchiaro is here tonight. Paul usually runs our soundboard here on Songwriters in the Round, so it's an honor and a privilege to have him on this side of the camera. And his partner, Jim Colangelo, who's a wonderful songwriter and a repair man for instruments and amplifiers and everything, right, Jim?
Yeah.
Over in Beverly. And my husband, Woody Woodward, featured as a songwriter on tonight's show.
Imagine that.
I know, it's about time.
I've been waiting patiently.
I know you have. And Woody's old partner, Steve Cucchiaro, who happens to be Paul's brother, but you know, this gets confusing.
You never get the same name.
And Steve's here playing with Woody tonight. They're going to do some songs that they wrote. And as a matter of fact, I think we're going to do a song right now that you wrote.
Right.
You want to tell us about this?
Is this one the performer?
Yes.
Good.
Okay.
This is a song that I wrote when I was, back in the 70s when I was playing with a band a group, I should say, the Shaw Brothers, and we played a lot, and we went overseas, and we went to Hawaii, and it was really a fun thing, and it got to be where I was thinking, gee, this is real professional. Pretty soon, I'm going to be hitting the big time. Well, it never happened, but this is kind of
well,
about that story.
It's happening now.
It's happening now.
That's true. Okay.
One, two, three. Standing there behind the curtain, waiting for the cue. Bated breath. He's the performer, the stage is his only home. He's had a share of lovers, but he got married long ago. Always dreaming of fame and fortune, cashing in the dues. Agents wait and speculate on every new tune. 'Cause he's the performer, the stage is his only home. He's had his share of lovers, but he got married long ago. Always wondered what it's like to sail the ocean, how it feels to have the waves on your side, or how it might be to fly the sky free, to have the wind on your side. Gets to wearing thin. 'Cause he's the performer, the stage is his only home. He's had his share of lovers, but he got married long ago. 'Cause he's the performer, the stage is his only home. He's had his share of lovers, but he got married long ago.
That when you were in Hawaii with the Shaw Brothers?
No, I wrote it after we got home, and It was one of those songs that just happened like in about 15 minutes. That's how long it took to write it.
Oh, those are the best ones. Well, a lot of people are going to be very happy to see Woody singing a song on the show. This is a show of firsts. First of all, we've got two basses, which we've never had on the show
Dueling
before.
Basses.
And actually, Richard and I are in the minority with acoustic instruments, and usually it's all acoustic, so this is kind of a different slant on our show. But we're going to turn our attention over to Jim Colangelo. And Jim and Paul Cucchiaro have had a group. What's the name of your group?
The Last.
Oh, okay. From Marblehead at the Landing, but...
Yeah, that was a few years back.
Yep.
We used to be in a group called Stonehouse a long time ago.
That's right.
Did we ever resurrect that name?
Ooh.
You know how those old names get with it.
And how many years ago was that?
Oh, that was maybe about 10 years ago.
Can't remember.
I can't remember. Back
that.
There. Yeah. But you guys play so well together. And I have the copy of your tape, which is really great. And I don't know, I you seem to be kind of like a Led Zeppelin sound, which is very interesting. Well, that's how that's how it struck me. But let's hear one of your songs.
Okay.
What are we playing?
Yes. Dream. Ready? One, two, three.
I've been dreaming. It is. Nice. It's a very dreamy song.
Yeah. You're
gonna lull yourself off. Now, that's a new one, right?
I wrote writing about that as, yeah. 10 minutes ago.
As we were rehearsing for the show, he was writing the lyrics.
Brand new for the show, yes.
Yeah, really great. Well, you guys have played together for years, though,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, 25 years.
Wow. Well, it shows because you really play well together, and the tape is great.
Thank you.
And now we're going to turn our attention back over to Steve Cucchiaro. Why don't you tell us what inspired you to write this song?
Well, I think a couple of things. First of all, I remember being up in the mountains skiing in New Hampshire. Mm. And it's a beautiful setting, a lot of snow, a lot of people all together in a ski house having fun. And then some of the people had to leave early. And I had all this time in my hands. I had 24 hours in my hands. I was alone, so it was a great time to think about writing a song. Mm-hmm. And at the time, I realized how nothing is certain, nothing lasts forever. And whatever you're doing, you might think it's going to be eternal, but it always changes, mm-hmm. whether it's change for the good or change for the bad.
Right.
But this was back in 1973, so
wow.
This song has been around for a long time.
Wow.
And in all those years, it's proven true.
It has proven true. And it's a beautiful song. This is called The Winds of Change. And Steve has to put on an acoustic guitar for this song.
Episode will surely cease. Hail to the winds of change. Hail to the winds of change.
Nice song, Steve. How many songs have you written?
I've written a few, maybe in the teens.
Yeah?
Not so many lately.
Yeah.
Something I enjoy. But like Woody said, sometimes you can work so hard at a song for days and days and nothing comes together. Mm-hmm. And other times it all comes together in a very short time.
Yeah, well,
those
that
are
was
usually the best.
Those are the best ones. And that was truly an inspired song. Mm-hmm. Yeah, very, very pretty. Well, before we get Jim to do another one of his songs, we want to mention that, and we know how good he is because we bring all of our guitars and our equipment over to Jim to be fixed.
That's right. By the way, Jim, is my bass fixed yet?
Actually, I had to take today off to be here.
Oh, that's right. Well, it's a good reason to take the day.
Yeah, right.
Now, what's the name of the business?
JC's Guitar Shop.
Okay. And I think we're going to put a little card or a little ad at the end of the show so people can call up, and your phone will be ringing off the hook when you get home today.
Good.
But let's hear another song.
Found that the range of voice is proportional to the loss of hair, you know, but
well, still can. You've got a beautiful voice.
Yeah.
And I didn't even know that you could sing, Paul.
Yeah.
The revelations are just abounding around here.
Yeah, so many things.
Well, I want to thank you all very much for being here, and it's great to have you on. This is one that I wrote not too long ago. I tried to, you know, I'm trying to do more rock things now. But this is called Talk So Tough, and we'll see you all again real soon. One.